secrets and treasures in Clockwork Knight 2.
Action! Action.
So Pepperchild III is back in part two of the Clockwork Knight saga. The first version ended with Princess Chelsea fast asleep, unable to wake up. Then suddenly, to add to her trouble, she's kidnapped. It's up to Pepper yet again to rescue the princess before sunrise. The gameplay is precisely the same as the first, but oh boy, did they spruce up the graphics. Everything is computer rendered, and the surroundings, from a huge bathroom, a library, and even the inside of a huge old clock, are colorful and fun. The animation is usually hilarious, and the bosses, all still incredible looking. This snake-like creature is the first one, and watch what happens when Pepper finally figures out how to kill it. The music has the same old bouncy, goofy style as before, playing under Sir Pepper Chow's constant, determined, busy march toward the rescue of Princess Chelsea, hacking to bits anything or anybody that stands in his way, or bopping them with a huge red polka-dotted egg. Just like with the first Clockwork Knight, you have to look everywhere for certain secrets and certain treasures, occasionally going through the same section more than once. Throwing stun enemies will help you get rid of multiple enemies at a time. If something on screen looks suspiciously different from the rest of the objects, such as a weird colored block or book, it's a good idea to try moving it. You might find yourself rewarded with extra time or energy. Clockwork Knight 2 is every bit as fun and more challenging than the first edition. Now, I know you're too sophisticated for a game about kids' toys, but check this one out. It's one of the best scroller adventure games out there.
Here's how we felt about Clockwork Knight 2 for the Sega Saturn. I really like this game a lot. It's got some pretty cool graphics, okay sound, the controls kind of goofy, but overall it's a lot of fun to play.
This game is acquired taste, and I think if you played the original, you probably will come back for more. I wasn't thrilled with the first one, and the graphics were just a little too cartoony for me.
Did you know that Clockwork Knight 2 has seven, that's right, seven hidden minigames? This is how you get to play them. Choose the Bosses Galore options, and while that title is on the screen, press up, up, right, right, down, down, left, left, X, Y, and Z. You'll hear a little tune and the word minigame will appear. Now choose Start to find the hidden minigame corner menu where you can choose to play seven games with the little Pepper Chow character from the loading screen. Forks is a funny game for Earthworm Jim 2 fans. You'll face a crazy driving challenge in Horsey. Cannon 1 is like a super fast version of Space Invaders. Now that should be enough to drive you cuckoo on Clockwork Knight 2. Check it out.
Here's the Twitch tip recap. To play the seven hidden mini games in Clockwork Knight 2, choose the Bosses Galore option. And while that title is on the screen, press up, up, right, right, down, down, left, left, X, Y, and Z. You'll hear a little tune and the word minigame will appear. Now choose Start to find the hidden minigame corner menu, where you can choose to play seven games with the little Pepper Chow character from the loading screen.